Hi, Mountain Song students. It's Mr. Adam here today. We learned recently about Hanukkah and some of the traditions around Hanukkah and some of the foods you eat around Hanukkah. So today I'm going to teach you how to make latkes, which are a type of potato pancake. So obviously for this recipe, you're going to need potatoes. You're also going to need an onion. You're also going to need one egg. I've got some eggs here. You're also going to need some flour. You could also use like matzah meal, which is a very popular ingredient in Jewish food. You could also use breadcrumbs, but you need something to help bind this all together. You're also going to need some salt and pepper to flavor your latkes, and you're also going to need some oil to fry this all in. So you're also going to need a nice large pan that you can cook these in. You're also going to need a lovely spatula to flip things with. You're also going to want a very big bowl. And then you're also going to need something to shred these potatoes. So I actually have a box grater here, but if you have a food processor at home, a lot of food processors have a special attachment that will shred things for you. You might need a parent or family member's help if you decide to do that, but I promise you, if you do have that tool, it will go a lot faster. So let's go ahead and shred our potatoes. I'm hoping that you can see this a little bit. Sure, that works. So I've already shredded some of my potatoes, but I'm going to shred one more along my box grater. And you can see as I'm shredding these potatoes, there's a lot of moisture on the box grater, and that's because potatoes hold a lot of water. So after we shred these potatoes, we're actually going to put them in a paper towel or a piece of cheesecloth or a regular kitchen towel works too, and we are going to squeeze all of the water out of our potatoes so that when they fry, they don't get all mushy. And if you're doing this by hand, it's going to be really difficult to shred the entire potato without cutting your fingers. So when I get down to a little bitty baby potato that I don't feel safe shredding anymore, I will just stick that to this side. So you can see all those lovely potatoes that I have just grated. So I'm going to add these to my bowl, and I already have two other potatoes that I have grated. So for your latkes, you want about three or four shredded potatoes, depending on how many you want to make. And of course, you can also double this recipe as well. So I have got all of my potatoes in here, and you can see that I went ahead and put a paper towel in here, and then I've already done my onion as well. So you are going to take half an onion, and you can shred that with your box grater or your food processor, or you can just chop it. But I've already got my onion ready to go, so I'm going to put that in my bowl as well. And onions also hold a lot of moisture, so they're going to get squeezed out too. So this is the really, really fun part. So I am just going to take my potatoes out. You can see that they're sort of nice and soggy. I've got another bowl right here. You can, of course, do that over the sink. But what I'm gonna do, and let's see if we can get it on camera. Oh, yes, look at that. I'm just gonna squeeze. Look at all that liquid that's coming out of the potatoes. Did you realize how much water was in potatoes? Something that we think is really sort of hard and starchy. So I'm just gonna squeeze as much of this liquid out as possible. And I think I'm gonna even need another paper towel. This to me is maybe one of the most fun parts of making latkes. And again, just squeeze as much of that as you can. And I've been squeezing for a while, and look, there's still a lot of liquid in there. And these don't have to be perfectly dry, but you do want to get as much of this moisture out of here as possible. And don't be afraid to really put some elbow grease in there. Squeeze as much as you can. So, I have got about as much moisture out of that as I think I can. So, I'm going to carefully sort of take these potatoes out of the paper towels and dump them in there. Make sure that you're not getting like pieces of paper towel in your latkes. So, just be really careful as you unravel this, because it is going to sort of look a little bit like a disaster after you've taken that off of there. And you can see, I'm gonna adjust my camera here, you can see how much liquid I drained off of those potatoes. Look at that. Wow. All right. So after we have got our potato and onion mixture, the next thing that you're going to do is add one egg, okay? So I'm gonna add that into my bowl. You're gonna also add about 2 tablespoons of flour or breadcrumbs or matzo meal. I've already got that measured out, so I'm gonna put that right in my bowl as well. And then you're gonna add your salt and your pepper. You can just do this to taste, but potatoes love salt, so don't be afraid of putting a lot in there. I'm also gonna add some pepper. And you can just do this to taste. Some people like a lot of pepper, some people don't. And now this is not necessarily traditional, but I really love garlic, so I'm gonna add a little bit of garlic powder. And you are welcome to add a little bit of garlic powder too, or maybe if you like things spicy, maybe you wanna add a little bit of paprika or red chili flakes. Again, that's not traditional, but feel free to add maybe one more herb or spice that you really, really like. So I've got everything in here, and I'm actually going to mix this up by hand. But before I do that, I'm going to switch my camera over here. I hope that you can see. Oh, yes, there we go. So I've got my pan on the stove. Let me turn on a light here. Yes. And now I'm going to go ahead and get my pan warmed up, and I'm going to go ahead and add my oil because we're essentially going to fry these in the oil. And so I'm going to cover the bottom of my pan in about 1/4 inch of oil. Okay, so don't be afraid to put a lot in here. I'm actually gonna add a little bit more, okay, so that we can deep fry these. And then I'm just gonna give it a nice swivel, make sure there's enough in there. That is lovely. So while that is heating up, I'm going to go ahead and start mixing my potatoes. And you can just do this with your hands. You don't even need to get a spoon. Don't be afraid to get messy, okay? And I should say too, as you're mixing this, you want everything to sort of be sticking together. So if you feel like your mixture is not sticking together, then you can add a little bit more of that binder. So again, whatever you chose to do, either the flour or the matzo meal or the breadcrumbs, but that is gonna be what helps make this sticky. But I think this is sticking together pretty well, see? And we'll be forming these into nice little patties in just a moment. All right, everybody, so I am back. My oil has been heating up for a few minutes on a medium-high heat. You don't want it to be too hot, but you don't want it to be too low either. And so I'm ready to start forming my latke patties. So I'm just gonna take a nice little handful here, all right, and just make a nice little patty about the size of my palm, you can see there. Now, I do not recommend putting this with your hands right into the oil because you can certainly get splashed or maybe even burned. So what I'm going to do, and I'm gonna lower my camera here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna put my latke right on this spatula and then just gently slide it into my oil. Ooh, and do you hear that nice little sizzle? That's a beautiful thing. And I've got another patty formed right here in front of me. So I'm gonna slide that into our pan as well. So just keep forming these patties with your hand. And again, mine are sticking together pretty well. You can see that, they're not really falling apart. And again, I just want to let this slide into the oil and don't crowd your pan. I think I can maybe fit 4 in here without making a mess. So again, I'm gonna shape another latke and then gently slide it into my pan. And you can see them sizzling and bubbling. We just want to cook them for a few minutes on each side until they're golden brown. So we'll just let these sizzle here, and then I might even just want to check on that first one that I put in to see how it's doing. Ooh. I went ahead and flipped that one. This one, ooh, that one looks lovely. And I'll try to show you on camera without getting oil everywhere. You can hopefully see how that is, ooh, that oil got me a little bit. Hopefully you can see how that is nice and golden and brown. So that's what you want it to be like when you flip it. And again, when you are frying things with oil, that can be a little dangerous. So you might just want to have an adult help you with this part of the latke making. Okay. I'm so hungry. These are going to be my breakfast today. So I have flipped all of my latkes. So they were probably all in there for about 2 to 3 minutes before I flipped them. I'm going to let them cook on the other side. And once they're golden brown, we'll take them out. And I should say, too, that latkes are best served warm. You're going to want to let them cool 1 or 2 minutes so that hot oil doesn't burn you. So actually, I'm going to go ahead and get some paper towels down on my plate, so that way when I take these out, the oil can sort of drain off and they're not super, super, super greasy. And I've still got a few more left in here that I can use. So I will probably get about 6 latkes out of my recipe, but I am just making these for myself. So if you have a larger family, you can certainly double or even triple or quadruple this recipe. It's pretty straightforward, easy thing to do. And again, I'm just checking on my latkes because I just want to make sure that they're not burning. And again, we want that nice, wonderful golden brown color. And while we're waiting on those to finish, you can just eat these latkes by themselves, but traditionally they are served with some lovely sour cream, which I love. You could also serve it with applesauce. Those are the most traditional things, but you could also put ketchup on here or sriracha, whatever you like with your potatoes. And I think maybe just 1 more minute on those bad boys. I'm gonna move my camera a little bit. So since they're sort of firmed up in the oil, I think I can get another latke patty in here. And again, I'm not going to put it in, use it in my hands. I'm just gonna let it slide out on the spatula just like that. And then it'll sizzle once it's in there. And that's pretty much the end of my batter. I do think it is time for me to take out my latkes. Ooh, yes. And you can see, look how nice and beautiful and crunchy and golden brown those are. I cannot wait to eat these. And the latkes will be really nice and crispy on the outside, and they will be sort of soft and mushy inside. So you don't need to have these cooked all the way through. And you're welcome to take another paper towel and sort of just pat these dry, get all that grease off. You can even flip them over. And I hope you can see how delicious and yummy these are. Oh my gosh, I cannot wait to eat them. I'm so lucky, right? To be able to have this for breakfast. And then I've just got 1 more latke sizzling away. I'll see if it's time to turn it. Oh, yes. So these are still very, 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 very hot. So give these a few minutes to cool down before you do it. And I should say, too, if you are making a lot of these, so again, I'm only making a serving for myself. If you're making a lot for a big family, what I would recommend is after you have made the latkes, you can either maybe put them in your microwave to keep them warm, or you could even turn your oven on very, very, very low, maybe just like 100 degrees, and you could put them on a cookie sheet and let them stay warm in there while you're making the rest of your latkes. So I'm going to finish making this one final latke while my others stay warm in the microwave, and then we'll come back in a few minutes and eat these, all right? All right, everybody, I am back. All my latkes have finished cooking. I don't think I'm going to eat all of these, by the way, but I'm definitely going to eat a few of them. And I just want to show you how nice and beautiful our latkes look. And what I'm looking like, they on camera, they look like they're a little dark, but I promise you they're perfectly golden brown and not burnt whatsoever. So I'm going to take one of these bad boys. I'm going to break it up. Look at that. It's so good. And I even have a little sour cream here that I'm going to dip it in. That's so good, everybody. I'm going to pat myself on the back. So that is how you make latkes. Pretty easy. Just remember, when you are frying the latkes, be very, very, very careful because that hot oil can be dangerous. And so don't be afraid to ask a parent or maybe an older sibling or someone in your family to help you do that part. But the rest of this should be pretty easy for you all. So have fun making these at home, and I look forward to hearing your stories of latke making. All right, happy Hanukkah. Have a good day, everybody. Bye.